How do we create an environment in which you can talk about HIV openly in the UK? I guess
it's about normalizing it,
yeah,
right?
Mm. Yeah.
It's about just as much as it is with mental health as well, being able to normalize the conversation around HIV because it is a virus.
Yeah, yeah.
And it is a virus that you can live with now, which was very, very different, you know, many years ago.
Yeah.
And again, for the younger generation, of which the majority of the world is made up of of people under the age of 30,
yeah,
then we have to put the power into the hands of the younger generation, because that's where the solutions are going to come from. That's where the passion and engagement is coming from as well.
Prince Harry was in Amsterdam on Monday meeting youth advocates who are driving change in the fight to end HIV and AIDS by the year 2030. They talked about the challenges and experiences of young people living with HIV, as well as the importance of placing youth at the forefront of the issues that affect them the most. In that conversation, Harry went on to say that at 33 years old, even he feels, quote, out of touch, and he believes that real policy change could be achieved if world leaders use the younger generation and all of their experiences. Today's talk follows Harry's ongoing efforts to tackle the various stigmas of the virus. He's publicly been tested for HIV, handed out self-testing kits, and given speeches on the importance of HIV/AIDS awareness and education. With this initiative, Harry follows in the footsteps of his mother, Princess Diana. One of her greatest legacies was her crusade to break the stigma surrounding HIV and AIDS in the 80s and 90s.